for the Ababu.
Well, young Rwandese fans there, raising the flag, singing, chanting, cheering, blowing that dreaded vuvuzela. For some it is dreaded, for some it is a wonderful toy.
I think the vuvuzela is the worst thing to ever come out of South Africa, to be quite frank with you. Cannot stand the noise, but fans all over the world seem to love it.
Well, a chance shot! Great save by Ndori! Ndori, great save! Really, really had to be at his very best there.
Yeah, he had to be alert because this chance came almost from nothing. I mean, one touch and the shot, he goes down to the ground. I think he's proven to be a brilliant shot stopper. Maybe not the best with crosses, but suddenly even the shots that come in late like that, he makes a stop.
Well, in the center of that run is defense. The substitute by Isenge Emery seems to be having a better game than his counterpart Eric Gasana. Eric Gasana a bit subdued. But so far, they're holding their own. Ochan. Not good enough from the header, finding Habib Kavuma. Kavuma stumbles down, all moving forward, but should have actually moved in the ball because they had space, but almost been caught in an offside position. Olivia Kaikes, but once again, Saba not getting the end of that cross. Masaba from Maloya. Iraneza has played a bit deeper today than previous games. Looking for Karekezi. Karekezi is beaten by Andy Mosikwa, the captain. The two captains clashing. Two captains contesting. Daka. Daka beating Oloya this time. Gabo. Long ball. But to no one.
Yeah, we had a frenetic start to this second half, but it sort of settled down. Of course, the fans still in full voice, but the players sort of eased off a little bit. It's almost as if they're going to coast down these last 5 minutes of the first half of extra time.
Leon Zima looking to control the midfield. Good fight back to Leon Zima. Changing flank. Oh, Megi Kadere beating the man. Beating the man, cross! Oh! At the end of that cross, just the header not accurate enough by Olivier Karekezi.
Yeah, I like this play. Again, Medi Kagere showing skillful footwork, beating his man, going in, and it's one of those really fast-paced crosses that needs just a touch of a direction from the player in the box. In this case, Olivier Karekezi does not quite get the touch, but I think the Rwanda number three, Habib Kavuma, cannot wait to see the last of Medi Kagere.
Yes, Kavuma under pressure. He's a makeshift. Clearance. Kasana. Good control. Second header on the ball. Neon Zima. Oh, good return, Neon Zima. Just the stretch there of Habib Kavuma. Winning. Rwanda. A corner. The fans there on the edge of their seats. Corner coming in. And no direction. Almost an own goal. They're claiming it. But it is a corner.
I don't really see what they're claiming. The goalkeeper is well within his right to punch that ball out. I mean, if you look at it, the corner comes in, it's headed, chested in, and I don't know what they're complaining about. It's perfectly legal to touch the ball with your hands if you're a goalkeeper, if it's chested in.
This time, Dira with a good ball, but a great defense there. And the contact once more, Yotima. Chukarita, cross coming in, looking for Medi Kagere. The header will come in from Masikwa. Chance for a shot! Oh, good save, Abidaira. Goes out for
the player with the afterburners in his boots has had quite a game as well. At that particular time, it was Jerome Sena for the umpteenth time testing the reflexes and skills of Abi Dairo. Test Jean-Claude Dory. He's looked nervous. See if they can capitalize on his nervousness.
Happy. Uganda 2-2.
I have to say, Herbert, that it has been 1 hour, 105 minutes of nothing but entertaining football. No cynical play, really. Both teams have clearly gone for it. The two goals are not here by accident. And now these brave, brave players, these hardy, hardy players, are going out to see if we can, if they can win this in regulation time.
Yes.
Actually, in regulation extra time.
Yes, Arnold, you got it there. But English is not our first language.
Yeah, as opposed to extra time, which is penalties.
Yes. The score, stalemate, a winner needs to come out in this second half period, extra time. A bit of an injury there, Albert Gabo, strong challenge on the right back, but he is on his feet, he knows there are no more substitutions.
Yeah, it's a strong challenge, but it's a stronger man. And again, it's a hard tackle, it's a tough challenge, but no cynicism about it, no ill intent evident.
Turning the favor and putting the ball straight into touch. The security, they are guarding that cup. The security to guard the Sakafa cup, because they must be a champion today.
They're actually quite tough, the Tanzania security. Crowd trouble is almost unheard of here. So a bit of a scuffle when we were last here in June. A fan tried to vandalize the stadium and paid for it dearly.
Uganda looking to attack once more. Tony Maweje, Saba Simeon, Oloya Ndaka, but he ran out of pitch and the ball out on the floor.
This player Oloya has really, really impressed me. He gets the ball, takes a touch, and then he seems to switch from first to fourth gear, beating the defender down on that right flank. He is absolutely fast.
Meri Kagere gives it to Kagabo. Kagabo easily beaten that challenge by the more experienced Tony Maweje. Simeon Masaba just take a pure with the ball, but still moving forward. Oloya crosses it. Indication of handball, but not given.
Shabara's top player for a player that's injured. Off for a shot right now, but I think it looks like that's exactly where he's headed. It's Peter Kagabo. It looks like Peter Kagabo took a knock and he's clutching onto his ankle there. It must be really painful. And of course, as you take a look at what happened in that clash between him and Tony Maweje, he came out there once more in that clean tackle, but the afters getting into Peter Kagabo, and Rwanda now has no more subs to make.
Yes, it will be unfortunate if the young man cannot come back onto the pitch. Milton Micho keeping his fingers crossed that second half substitute will recover back to Uganda. So the shot blocked. Any chance for a shot? All sixes and sevens in that Rwandese goal mouth, but eventually a clearance does find its way.
There was a bit of hesitation in getting that shot off. A crowd of white shirts.
Daka looking for support. He's one man less on that flank. Kagabo not yet back on the pitch, but the referee arouses him back now. They are back to their full complement. Graneza. Strong, strong challenge. The challenges are coming fast and furious again. This time it was Karekezi. The two captains colliding, Karekezi and Wesigwa. Wesigwa just feeling pain in some very private area.
Yeah, and it's evidence of how physical this match has been. If you take a look at his jersey there, it looks like he needs buttons for it. That was a collision to me, if nothing else, because Mosigwa gets caught in the face, but Sibs will get carded for all his troubles.
Of course, Adam Singer gets a yellow card there. Actually, a guilty party. Rwanda take it. They want to move with it. Rwanda patiently building. But a cut up there. Asaba, Oloya. Oloya puts it up front. Looking for Hamis Kiza, the fresh of the strikers who's come on. But Mary Bayisenge just being sure. Ndore marshals his troops at the back.
I think they should send an in-swing. I keep testing Jean-Claude Ndore.
And it comes Ndore, but this time Ndore does very, very well. One of the better crosses he has taken this afternoon. At least that will give him confidence.
Yeah, that's a welcome confidence boost. He had a man coming up behind him, Andrew Mosigwa. He goes up commandingly inside his six-yard box, grabs that, comes down with it, and that goes a long way in erasing the memory of all the ones he's fluffed at.
Strong header. Patrick Ochan looking for Sula Matovu on that left wing. Oh, Matovu does well to beat Gabo. Matovu, 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 Matovu! No return. Shot coming in wide.
Yeah, I think Sula Matovu does well to beat the defenders, does well to get into the area. The final cross, that's what he needed to do. But Hamis Kiza, maybe not the right height for him. And then Moses Oloya with a follow-through sends that wide. But that was a really, really open chance for Uganda to try to take the lead and possibly the title.
22 minutes into the extra time period. It is still on the World of Champions. Rwanda 2, Uganda 2 in this CECAFA Task Challenge Cup final, the 36th edition. A thriller minute. What a game it is. Looking for Hamis Kiza. Ball is in touch already. Osaba not able to keep it. Ishiabaro, the referee, the man in our picture, given the honor of being the policeman in this final.
And I have to say, he's acquitted himself with distinction, has kept the game fair, kept his cards in his pocket unless absolutely necessary, and policed, as you put it, over a match that has been nothing short of a good advertisement for not just the game in Eastern Central Africa, but the game as a whole.
But they will be watching this game in Mogadishu and feeling very proud that their man is at the center of this game. And it is a long run. Isinde, Isinde, searching for Isinde. Shot! Should it have done that?
Yeah, he had options, and that's why maybe they said defenders shouldn't shoot. His goal was spectacular, but on this one, he just kept going and going and going. I think he should have put his head up and taken a look at what other options he had. Bobby Williamson seems to agree with that idea.
Yes, I mean, he's on a very enviable record for a defender. 2 goals in 2 games, but he knows that, he should know that his primary function is a defender. Mitchell, the coach, previous in our picture there, just giving the instructions, hasn't sat down the whole game.
Yeah, it's been hard to sit down. I mean, if you're a fan, if you're anybody watching this game, you and I have had a sitting down because we must. But on more than one occasion, we've gotten up off our seats here at the commentary booth. Such has been the thrills and spills that this match has served up.
Tony Mawenje to Masaba. Masaba. Masaba back to Oloya. Oloya not able to beat Ndaka. Ndaka finally gets the better of Oloya this time. Careless by Ndaka, but support. Still, Ochan. Ochan looks for Kavuma. Kavuma able to retain it in the center. Oh, Oloya offside. Doesn't even find the target, but he's already offside, Oloya. But good build-up from Uganda, good build-up.
Yeah, Oloya has been dangerous all game. That cross comes in very, very close. He takes the shot and hits the crossbar with Jean-Claude Ndore beaten, but wouldn't have counted.
Wouldn't have counted. This Oloya, our picture man, has had a very, very splendid game. 25 minutes gone. We are starting to that will be smelling penalties. Look at that trophy, the glittering trophy, the CECAFA Tusker Cup. This is what the two teams are fighting for, in addition to the monetary reward of $30,000 for the winner and $20,000 for the runner-up, together with a glittering array of medals, gold and silver.
And of course the pride of being champions of Eastern Central Africa, champions of the oldest, one of the oldest international football tournaments there is. Remember the CECAFA Cup inaugurated in 1974. But it's precursor, the Gossage Cup, dating back to 1936, which is even before the World Cup. So it's one thing that East Africa can be proud of, a contribution to international football. They've been playing international football in this part of the world much longer than they've been independent countries.
True. Okwi, Emmanuel Okwi, looking for a strike partner, Hamis Kiza, but cut out there by Emery Bayisenge. Keeping tabs with Eric Kasana there. Kasana trying to raise the morale of the team. Under 4 minutes. Isaac Isinde. Habib Kafuma crossing it in, but no one, and it's cleared. Tony Maweje. Looking at his options, but another strong header from Bukiraneza, clearance by Castena. Masaba, Maweje, Masaba. Kiza cut out there by Bukiraneza, playing it cool to Eric Kasana. Kasana just boots it, with any purpose, and it finds Masaba once again. Masaba, Ochan shot! Great save, Dori once again. Well done, Dori.
Yeah, Jean-Claude Dori has not had a problem of any sort with taking the shots. Patrick Ochan gets that, let's fly, but Jean-Claude Dori good to the task, and not for the first time, he keeps running this match.
Yes, and called upon again after that corner. Rwanda looking to counter, but possession is with Uganda. Isaac Isinde, what's he doing with the flank? Sina Matobu just on the receiving end of some strong challenge there, tearing his shirt. If that's what's going to get the goals, so be it.
Yeah, it does look like he might need buttons of that at the end of the match, but I think he does not mind too much. They've put in a free kick in a very, very enterprising position here. And you get the feeling that this might be one of the last meaningful attacks for Uganda, if not in the match altogether. It says a lot for the fitness of these players, a brave, brave effort they've put in. 6 matches, 14 days, extra time for both, for both teams today and for Uganda in the match on Thursday against Tanzania.
Ricky comes in, over the bar. No pressure. Manuel Okwi, the responsibility of taking the free kicks. Maybe should have been turning away, there's a chance.
Max Remark has been on the bench since the 65th minute of this match. And as we look to Jean-Claude Dori to launch what might probably be one of the final attacks of what has been an enthralling and absorbing match.
Over just less than a minute to the end of this extra period, we are smelling penalties more and more. Eric Ndaka in our picture. Simeon Masaba, conjure some magic. Ochan, Masaba, Maweje. Maweje just trying a tricky shot, but nothing that will trouble Jean-Claude Dori. Seconds ticking, Okwi just putting some pressure.
And if you see Jean-Claude Dori taking his time like that, it tells you this is a goalkeeper who passes his chances of penalties. We've already seen him stopping shot after shot after shot. I think he's thinking, you know what, let's get one last chance, and we don't, guys. I've got your backs. Penalties, it's on the money.
1 minute added time. Uganda with a chance there, but cut out by Eric Gasana. Tony Mawenje fighting but losing the shot. Kagabo looking for Karekezi. Karekezi Masikwe. The two captains. Nakusuge having the last word in that. And Wishia Barrow brings extra time. Proceedings to an end. We now move to the next phase of this game. The game must produce a winner. The two goalkeepers will come more and more into focus now. It is, as they say, the dreaded penalty shootout. Jerome Sina faded off in this second half extra time, but had a sterling game so far. Emmanuel Okui would have loved to find the back of the net. Dory shaking hands with the opposing coach. They congratulated for a sterling performance. Kept my strikers at bay, but at the end of extra time, full time, it is Rwanda 2, Uganda 2, and this is a CAFA Tusker Challenge Cup final, the 36th edition of this competition in East Africa. Now they say the devil's lottery.
Yeah, and I mean, these are the goals from this game. That was great, great defending. Musa Mude dispossessed, while he was still complaining. Jean-Claude Ranzi keeps going, and he went and went and went, finding Medi Kagera, who lets that fly into the far post, goes to the side netting. Again, you would have wanted Abby Dairy to have done better with that. Then this is the Ugandan one. Jean-Claude Ndori was very, very suspect on crosses. He was found well out of position there. Isaac Isinde says, thank you very much. And puts at the back of the net, but immediately after, Medi Kagera makes up for his goalkeeper, gets the ball, puts his marker on the ground, Habib Kavum, and then scores. And you can tell from the Sabu celebration, he loved that. But then this one, unfortunately, the sixth goal for Olivier Karekezi this tournament is an own goal, even though Habib Skiza claims it.
Yes, Arnold. Well, it's that time when the goalkeeper becomes the focus of attention. You can see Mitchell there just adding whatever more extra stretch he can do to make him taller.
Yep, limbering up there, Bobby Williamson. I don't know how the different coaches do it, but back in my time, the coach would simply ask, all right, who's feeling up to this, and people would step forward. They say it takes a brave player to take penalties, but I think it takes a player who's confident and who knows that we're called upon. Who's taking for his team?
You know, when you win, so you wish. You start. No. Either you choose one or two. I have your right. Then it takes a second. That's good for you.
You win.
You need the first or two?
Two.
You begin.
Okay?
You begin.
Well, Coleman, the toss went to Rwanda. And Uganda will start taking the penalties. Uganda will be first to take the penalties. Players just receiving last-minute instructions if there is such a kind of thing for penalties.
Well, it's basically what they need to do is to stretch, to relax, to focus their minds, shut out the noise from the stadium, shut out the lactic acid building up in their muscles, the fatigue, the exhaustion, the dehydration, and just know that they've got one shot. And it really is not difficult. I remember the great Rivaldo, Barbosa, the Brazilian striker, used to wonder why players miss penalties. He's never missed a single one. But of course, after he played 6 matches in 2 weeks, played extra time, it really becomes difficult.
Stating United Against Malaria is the CSR project, corporate social responsibility project for this CECAFA tournament. So this tournament also has good community work being done. And remember, malaria is a killer in this continent of Africa. So CECAFA has partnered with this effort in supporting the fight against malaria.
Yeah, it's a brilliant effort. Malaria, the leading killer of children under 5 in this part of the world. So it is good that even as we enjoy the football, we do service the community. But Herbert, on to the business on the pitch.
Yes, and the penalties will be taken on the south end. The south end, Rishi Abara just pointing south. And a man from Somalia with his supporters in Mogadishu will be in charge of the penalty shootout of this 36th edition. Abi Daira there, all his cockiness will be put to test today. And Dory has been in fine form, just the two goalkeepers just talking advice from the bench keeper to the starting keeper. Take it easy, watch the feet, don't watch the ball. Or if it was the ball, don't watch the feet.
They usually say these days, I mean, it's been scientifically proven to be impossible to see the ball and react in time to move. So they tell the goalkeepers, pick a spot and just commit to it.
The two players just huddle in the center. They have been through this before. Finals, in the 2003 final, Uganda got the better of Rwanda. In the 2009 final in Nairobi, Uganda once again got the better of Rwanda. Isaac Kisinde will be the first player to take the penalty for Uganda. To be Kisinde versus Dory. Dory just saying another prayer. He's been very prayerful. I've said all their prayers.
You can almost feel the tension in this match. I mean, penalties, not too much to be said about them, except it's one player on the spot. Keeper doesn't need to do anything, but he makes a save. He's a hero. The striker could be the villain.
Isinde rests up inside. 1-0 to Uganda.
Yeah, and he's relieved. Jean-Claude Dory wishes he'd seen a bit better of that, but this is how you take a penalty. Goes wide, hits the side netting, sends the goalkeeper the wrong way, no chance. Very, very few goalkeepers in the world can get that, even if they dive the right way. In this case, Dory went the wrong way. You see the wrong foot team and gets the first one for Uganda.
Eddie Kagere, joint tournament goal scorer, will be taking the first penalty. They say don't let your regular scorers take the first penalty. Abi Daira in goal against Medi Kagera. Medi versus Daira. Inside, easily taken.
Yeah, and Medi Kagera, the picture of focused concentration there, as is his coach, Mulitini Mitchell. Medi Kagera goes a bit down the middle, but it does send Abi Daira the wrong way. Look at the focus on his face. He knew exactly where he was going to place that. Hits the back of the net, and that is the mark of a well-taken penalty. 1-1.
1-1 it is. And Moses Koloya will be taking the second penalty for Uganda. Goalkeeper gives him the ball. Maybe some a way of just adding nerves onto Koloya. Koloya versus Dory.
By Dory. We did say he was a shot stopper. We did say he looked more confident doing the penalties. Aloya looked a bit nervous there. It was a well-taken penalty. It takes, you can see the focus on his face, but Dory read that clearly, got off his line in time, hands up in the air as a result of that. Moses Aloya misses, crestfallen as indeed he should be. Consolation from his teammates.
Haruna Niyonzima versus Abi Daira.
basically put Uganda on the ropes, run up competently, and he had it nicely placed, but maybe a bit too nice, was trying to tuck it away into that far left corner, sent the goalkeeper the wrong way, but sent the ball the wrong way in the grander scheme of things. Comes off the upright and back in, I think Abi Dairy very, very relieved. Emery Bayisenge, look of frustration on his face as he walks back to his teammates.
The crane flies over the wasp. congratulating the Rwandan players for an excellent, excellent final. Uganda winning 3-2 on penalties on this. And we go downstairs and hear what the coaches have to say.
There we have it. The champions of 2011 are Uganda Cranes after a fantastic, scintillating final game in this competition. And by my side is Coach Micho, who has led his team unbeaten until this particular moment. This particular moment, what is going through your mind right now?
It's very hard to talk, you know. This is a drama which only football can make. You're leading 1-0, and you're leading 2-1. And you are leading two penalties advantage, then you are losing the match. It's very hard to be firm, to accept this, but this is what the football is. We need to accept it. We need to analyze where problem was and to look to come strong. After only 1 month and 10 days working with this team, I think that we have gone a very long road, that we have reached very far from that 40 days. Piece of luck was the reason why we didn't take the trophy. It is very painful to talk about, but this is football. We need to accept it.
Coach, from now, what's next for your team? What